All right, so I decided to not do the to make the delaminate cores with one iron infused and then alternating with a regular PLA. I decided to go completely with the iron infused PLA. One of the things I was surprised about, and I shouldn't be too surprised, so here's a stack of 20 straight PLA plastic pieces. I bring it over to, oops, let me see if I can get it right, trying to do this one-handed. Hold on. Let me bring it over to the scale, and I have it set up for grams. Drop it on the scale. Come on. And it doesn't even register. Okay. Take the same amount, 20, and drop that on the scale, and it registers as 26 grams. So I was really surprised. These are surprised, and I noticed it when I was picking up the bulk of them like this. I noticed how heavy they felt compared to the, and I guess it's not surprising. It's iron infused, but I didn't think it was that much of a difference. So now I'm kind of second guessing. Maybe I should alternate because the drag on this guy, when this coil was energized, when I tried to use it to run the beast rotor, and it wasn't mounted down, it was flipping back and forth. Not when it was doing the pickup operation, but when I was trying to actually get it to fire and run the rotor, I abandoned it because I didn't have a way to securely hold this down. For pickup purposes, which you guys remember yesterday was producing 21 volts of AC. For pickup purposes, it's fine. But when I energize the coil and it magnetizes the ferrite air core, it really pulls against the magnet. I was really surprised. I didn't think it would be that strong. And now I'm thinking if I put these inside here, that may make a really strong ferrite core. So, yeah. But I'm thinking if I alternate them, would it still have the same effect? It should. So I think I'm just going to go with the solid core. Yeah, I'm just going to go with the solid core, and I'm going to make it in a way where I can take it in and out of this coil and Sky Collection coil. But yeah, I was really surprised by the difference in weight. It's considerably heavier. Anyway, stay tuned. Sorry about the last terrible camera angle. Sorry, I had to pause the video there for a second. Yeah, sorry about the lousy camera angle. I was showing the weight difference between the iron infused PLA and the regular PLA, and there's a significant difference, which I shouldn't be surprised by that because it's iron infused. Anyway, I've measured out the size of the hole for this coil, and I've got it as tight as I can get it and probably as straight as I can get it. What I'm going to do is put some thin set CA glue in there. Just by pouring it right down here, it should seep in there and tighten it together, I'm hoping. I don't want to do one at a time and all that nonsense. I should do it with the regular number 16 acrylic, but I think the CA glue will work just fine. So I'm going to get that all set, and then I have to figure out a way to mount it. I'll probably just take what, like one of these guys out. I'll either take this one out, which will be easier than taking this one out. This one I mounted to a piece of acrylic and just hot glued the acrylic to the base there. I don't know how it, yeah, it should still work. It should still be okay as far as the thickness goes. Anyway, I would much rather use this coil for the testing though, because it is a single wound coil, and that's what I wanted to test with. The problem is I don't think I can get this guy in there easily anyway. All right, so let me go back and make sure this is nice and straight and get it glued up. Stay tuned. Nab it. I always do this. So I think the thin set CA glue is going to work. I just put some on all four sides. And then I thought, why am I not using resin? I have resin. So once the CA dries, I'll paint it up with some resin. I want to make sure that the inside gets stuck. I know that CA glue and resin don't really like to play together, but we'll see. Stay tuned. Yeah, so I have a bunch of different resins, but I think I'm going to use this little thing of clear cast I have. That seems to be the best for this application. I have some other resins over there, but I think I'm going to go ahead with this clear cast and just paint a thin coat on it, just to kind of seal the outside of it. I don't know. Yeah. Ciao. All right. So that's the first coat. I think that'll work out okay. Don't know if I'm going to need another coat or not, but I probably will put one on. The only problem I have now is I can't let it stay like that, because that resin will eventually start to go down no matter how thin I made it. So I'm going to have to monitor it for a while. If anybody knows, excuse me, how to, if heat sets resin quicker, it's very cold in my shop. So I'm wondering if I blast it with my heat gun I got hanging up there. If I blast it with the heat gun, not intensely, but just a little bit, will that help set it? If anybody knows, if you care, leave a comment. Thanks. Ciao. So I think the best way to do it is how I always do it when I have a situation like this. I'll leave it in the vise like that for like 15 minutes and come out, spin it around. 15 minutes, come out, spin it around. Do it like every 15 minutes. And within probably like an hour or so, it should set. Yeah, I can't wait to get trying. I don't know why I couldn't get, well, I do know why I couldn't get it to run using the JL94 motor, because I couldn't get this thing stationary, like I said before. But I'm dying to try it. Maybe if I, maybe if I just put like a clamp around this. Yeah, let me try that. Let me try putting like a zip tie. Oh, I can't. Yeah, I can drill a hole in that. Yeah, let me try that. Stay tuned. Yay, my diodes just came in so that I can make my bridge rectifier. Even though I have several rectifiers that I bought, I want to make my own. But I'm not sure if this is the right diode. I wanted one that can stand, I mean, withstand some higher voltage and amperes. So these are 3-amp diodes. They're the, I don't know if that is the model number. I have a bunch of diodes already. I don't know if these are, if these will work, but I will find out. Yeah, cool. They came in, man. And this guy's looking awfully gray, kind of like metal. Cool. All right, so now I'm using it as a drive coil. I jerry-rigged it. Because it's a small coil, it's not as powerful as this one or this one, but it is working nicely. But I don't know. Let me make sure nothing's getting hot. I think I need to push it a little bit closer. Let me see if you guys can see that gap there. Let me pause this because I don't have the stand, but it's working nicely. I'm thrilled because I thought for some reason it wouldn't work. But I am getting a weird pulsing that I don't normally get. Obviously on the camera, my tape just dropped. Obviously on the camera, it pulses really bad, but even in person, it's not that bad. Let me pause this and see if I can get it closer. Pause. No, that's about as close as I can get it before it starts hitting. Now, let me turn it up and see what happens. volts. Yeah, it's okay for a drive coil. It's much better for a pickup coil, though. That's really weird. It's causing my camera on my phone to do weird stuff. So in real life, it's pulsing pretty fast. On my camera, obviously, it pulses slower. Oops. The coil's cool to the touch. It's not hot. None of the circuits are hot. So I don't know that it makes a big difference as a drive coil, having the ferrite core. Does make a big difference as a pickup coil. But, you know, it works. It works great too. But again, I don't think it makes much of a difference. All right, ciao.